With the unpredictable winter weather in the Twin Ports, the City of Superior has rolled out a new tool for people to stay safe. The city has installed GPS systems in its snow plowing fleet. Almanac North producer Megan McGarvey spoke with Mayor Jim Payne and a snowplow driver about the new system.
It's always important to maintain and upgrade Superior's fleet. This is a winter city, and it always has been. And so every generation, every couple years, we should be looking to be more efficient and make sure that winter doesn't negatively impact people's day-to-day lives. And as technology and equipment improves, we need to invest in that.
Our sander fleet is just the first of the trucks that are going to be getting these GPS systems. Eventually, the rest of our snowplows will have them as well. The best influence this has when it comes to having the GPSs is that everyone is informed. We can help increase our flow when it comes to getting areas done. Once an area is completed, we can see maybe there's ways to better go about an area.
When we first started talking about it, I think we all had a little bit of a blind spot thinking the technology was more complicated than it is. In reality, we realized we already have these devices on our police vehicles. We track them all the time. So then we upgraded from there, and it really is ended up being Verizon that provided the devices and the software. The existing software shows you where the plows are and what direction they're going, but we also know where they've been. Very soon we're going to show that as well. So when you're about to leave the house, you'll be able to look at whether or not your street's been plowed, or whether or not a street two blocks away has been plowed, or how many of the mains and collector routes have been plowed and sanded. And so our goal is more or less total transparency. The only thing that's holding it up is making sure that we can collect and display that information in an efficient and timely way that the public can easily read and understand. And so as we improve our software and our ability to share it, it's all gonna go out.
Being a driver for the Thanksgiving storm, that one was probably the longest storm of my life and hopefully for the rest of my life. Subsequent back-to-back 16 hours for 2 weeks just to get the city cleared. And then after that, another, I believe it was 2 months of 12-hour shifts to get the city ready for the next storm.
The 2019 storm led to some of the most significant conversations we've had about the operations of our snow clearing and removal within the city of Superior. That storm raged like almost no other storm I've seen in my life throughout the night. And because it was so much snow and so wet and heavy, it created a unique experience for regular citizens. First, we could not keep up with it. The plows ran from the very first flurries and stayed out all night at great risk to their own safety. But to the public, they thought that they weren't even out. Then at one point, we had to pull those sander trucks. They literally weren't heavy enough to plow the snow anymore, and so we had to replace them with heavy tractors. The messaging, though, was very easily confused with, we pulled the plows off the road, which was not true. We were plowing the streets, but it sounded like we weren't. And it looked like we weren't because we didn't get to most streets. It took so long, and the snow came just filled up everything we plowed.
I think the GPSs will, for a certain value, help people understand what's going on in a storm situation, like the November storm of 2019. There's only so much it can do, though. Really, it'll only give you an idea of where the plows are, hopefully in the future, where they have been, so that you know what areas are relatively clear. But in a storm like that, there's only so much you can do to keep up.
It's also worth noting that climate change is having an effect. We are getting more precipitation, heavier snow, more often, and Superior was in terms of being a winter city, it was mostly a cold city. We didn't get as much snow as other parts of northern Wisconsin or Minnesota. Now we do, and so that means we have to adapt. Fighting climate change is the work of nations and the whole world. Protecting ourselves against its effects, that's the work of cities.
And with the new technology, you can track Superior snow plows during winter storms. Just go to the city website and search for Truck Tracker.